This is Ankita Rajput and today we will be discussing about crystal planes or crystallographic planes, and later we will be discussing about the Miller indices as well. Okay, so I hope you know about the crystal lattice. Okay, if you don't know about the crystal lattice, you can watch our previous video as well. So the term crystal planes comes from the crystal lattice itself. Okay, so crystal planes kya hote hain? To further study and visualize some properties of crystal, we discuss about the crystal planes. Okay, so the concept of crystal planes is helpful to find some properties of the crystal. So crystal mein we have so many atoms are situated. Okay, so these crystal planes are those planes, basically these are the imaginary planes, and these planes passes through the atoms and molecule present in the crystal. Okay, and most of the crystal planes are the planes which pass through the highest density of atom and molecule. Okay, so like this is your crystal, this is basically simple cubic crystal, and the atoms are situated only at the corner of this structure. Okay, so this is a simple cubic crystal, and there may be so many planes. Like this will be your plane and this will also be your plane. Okay, so we have six faces here, and all the six we can consider as planes. Okay, so these are the crystal planes. So basically these planes are imaginary planes, and these planes help us to visualize some properties and further study of the crystal. Okay, so you might be thinking, what is the need of crystal planes? Why we are studying about the crystal planes, and what is the physical significance of crystal planes? Okay, so as you know, we have so many planes in crystal, and we have different planes, and these planes contains different atoms or molecules. That means atomic density or molecular density is different in different planes. Okay, so we can say each plane is different and it contributes some unique properties of crystal. Okay, so we have some properties and some characteristics of crystal, and these properties are influenced by its planes. Okay, like we can say we have optical properties. If there is a crystal and light is passing through this crystal, so how the propagation of light is taking place, it also depends on crystal planes. Because if you know about the orientation of these planes in crystal, you can better tell about the propagation of light through a crystal. Okay, so surface tension also influenced by the crystal planes. If your crystal is under some kind of tension, okay, so surface energy kis type se propagate hogi, flow hogi inside the crystal, it will also depends on the crystal planes. Okay, and dislocation also, and X-ray diffraction. If you know about the X-ray diffraction pattern, the spectrum contains some peaks, and these peaks directly related to the crystal planes. Okay, so the study of crystal plane is very very important, because it further describe so many properties, important properties of the crystal lattice. Okay, so it's very important to study the crystal planes so that we can understand about the crystal and some of its properties. Okay, so for further understanding of crystal planes, we need to understand about the Miller indices. Okay, so this may be a familiar term to you, Miller indices, and this is a concept which is given by the British scientist William Miller, and he was basically a crystallographer, and he gave this concept to find the orientation of the crystal planes. So Miller indices, it's basically a notation system, and by using this system we can specify the planes and directions also in the crystal system. Okay, and basically Miller indices is a group of three integers H, K and L, and these integers shows the orientation of a plane or group of planes inside a crystal. Okay, so if we want to write the orientation of a single plane, we write HKL in this way. Okay, so this term represent a single brain. But if we have a family of brains, okay, so we represent the family of brains in this way, okay. And if we write HKL in this way, it represents the direction, a single direction. And for family of direction, we write HKL in this way, okay. So just remember all these four notation, different notations, and these are very important, okay. So if some integer is in opposite direction, negative number, so for this we denote a bar on top of it, okay. So this will show the direction, negative direction of the integer, okay. Okay, so Miller gave the method to identify the Miller indices of a crystal plane. Okay, so for this we have a few steps here. If there is a crystal plane, a plane inside a crystal, and you know there are three crystallographic axes inside a crystal, x, y and z axis. So first you need to identify the intercept of this plane on these three axes. Okay, so first step, you need to find out the three intercepts of the plane on these three axes respectively. Okay, so after the intercepts, you need to take the reciprocals of these intercepts. Okay, so this will be your second step. And finally, if there is some fraction remain, you just need to simplify the term, and after that just write the numbers in parentheses, okay, and without any space and comma. Okay, so if there is some kind of fraction, so aapko simplification kar dena hai LCM leke, and you उसके बाद आपको इस ब्रैकेट के अंदर उन टर्म्स को लिख देना है विदाउट एनी स्पेस और कोमा. सो फाइनली यू विल गेट योर मिलर इंडिसेस HKL फॉर दिस प्लेन. ओके, सो वी कैन टेक फ्यू एग्जांपल्स टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द मिलर इंडिसेस. ओके, सो ये आपका कोई क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल सिस्टम है, एंड सपोज दिस इज योर प्लेन. ओके, दिस इज योर क्रिस्टल प्लेन. सो आपको क्या करना है, फर्स्ट this plane intersect the x axis at a point A. Okay, so here this is x axis, and this is a cubic crystal system having dimension A. So this plane intersect the x axis at point A. Okay, and this plane you can see is parallel to y axis and z axis also. So okay, so what will be your step one? You need to calculate or find the intercept of this plane on three axes. So for convenience we will take A equals to 1. So the intercepts of this plane are 1, infinite and infinite on x, y and z axis respectively. So clear? X axis पे आपका प्लेन कट करता है एट पॉइंट A. सिंप्लीफिकेशन के लिए आपने A को कंसिडर कर लिया 1. एज दिस प्लेन इज पैरेलल टू y एक्सिस एंड जेड एक्सिस, एंड ये प्लेन पैरेलल है इन दोनों एक्सिस के, दैट मीन्स कहीं भी कट नहीं कर रहा, तो दैट मीन्स आपका इंटरसेप्ट क्या हुआ, इनफाइनाइट फॉर बोथ वाई एंड जेड एक्सिस के लिए. ओके, स्टेप टू में यू विल टेक रेसिप्रोकल्स ऑफ दीज इंटरसेप्ट. सो आपका रेसिप्रोकल क्या हो जाएगा, 1/1, 1/infinite, एंड थर्ड टर्म हो जाएगी 1/infinite. सो सिंप्लीफिकेशन होगा आपका 1/0/0. ओके, सो थर्ड स्टेप आपका क्या होगा, हमने क्या पढ़ा था, इफ देर इज एनी फ्रैक्शन तब हम सिंप्लीफिकेशन करते हैं, बट हेयर आपका टर्म ऑलरेडी सिंपल है, देर इज नो फ्रैक्शन. सो आपका मिलर इंडिसेस हो जाएगा 1/0/0. सो आप कैसे लिखेंगे पैरेंथेसिस के अंदर, 1/0/0, देर इज नो कोमा, नो स्पेस. ओके, सो दिस विल बी योर HKL, मीन्स 1/0/0 इज द मिलर इंडिसेस ऑफ दिस प्लेन. ओके, क्लियर, वी विल डिस्कस दिस एग्जाम्पल नाउ. ओके, सो दिस इज योर क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल सिस्टम. ओके, एंड दिस इज योर प्लेन. ओके, यू कैन सी द प्लेन कट्स ऑल द थ्री एक्सिस एट सेम पॉइंट ए. ओके, एंड फॉर सिंप्लीफिकेशन हमने ए को 1 ले लिया है. सो स्टेप 1 में द इंटरसेप्ट्स ऑफ द प्लेन्स विल बी 1/1/1 ऑन द थ्री एक्सिस एक्स, वाई एंड जेड रेस्पेक्टिवली. ओके, सो in step 2 we will take the reciprocal of the intercepts, and the reciprocal will be same 1/1/1, right? So this is also a simple term, there is no fraction. So In step 3, you can directly write like this. Okay, so your Miller indices for this plane will be 111. Okay, so इसी crystal के अंदर we will take one more plane. Okay, so this is your plane and this plane cuts the axis, all the three axes at the middle point. Okay, so if this is A, this will be A by 2 and this will also be A by 2 and A by 2. Okay. Okay, so for this plane, green plane, the intercepts will be half, half, half. Okay, because it cuts equally on the three axes. So, the intercept will be 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 on three axes. Okay, and when you will take the reciprocals, it will be 2, 2, 2. Right? You can simplify, further simplify this term. Okay, you can divide the term by 2 because all these three terms are equal and so after simplification, it will be 1, 1, 1. So, Miller indices for this plane, green plane will be 1, 1, 1. For this plane, first plane, the Miller indices were also 1, 1, 1. And for this plane, green plane, the Miller indices are also 1, 1, 1. So, that means all the parallel planes inside a crystal have same Miller indices. Okay. So, this plane, green plane, is parallel to this plane. Okay. So, for parallel planes, Miller indices are same. Okay. So, this is very important concept. Okay. So, aapka next example bhi cubic crystal system mein hai. This is your crystal and this is your plane. Okay. So, if you find some difficulty to find out the intercepts of the plane on the axis, you can do one thing. Okay, so like this plane intersects at y-axis here and also at x-axis here. Okay, so you can just write and find out the coordinate of these two points. Okay, so on y-axis the plane cuts here, so the coordinate of this point will be 0 1 0. Okay, because it's on y-axis, so there is no term will be in x and z axis, so the coordinate are simply 0 1 0. Okay, so the plane also cuts x-axis at this point and this is a middle point of this side. Okay, so the coordinate of this point will be 1 by 2 and again for y and z 0, 0. Okay, so these are the two points. Okay, so the intercepts of the plane on the three axes will be x, y and z. For x, it will be 1 by 2. For y, the intercept will be 1. And as the plane is parallel to z axis, the plane is parallel to z axis, so the intercept will be infinite for z axis. Okay, so this will be your intercepts. So find the reciprocal of the intercepts and it will be 2 1 0. Okay, so there is no fraction, so simply the Miller indices for this plane will be 2 1 0. So this is your plane having Miller indices 2 1 0, right? So again, this is also cubic crystal system. Okay, and this is your plane, right? So the intercepts of the plane are 1 1 2. Okay, x-axis pe it cuts here, so this is 1. Y-axis pe it also cuts here, so this is 1. And for z-axis, we take 2 unit cells. Okay, so these are the same unit cells. And if this is 1, this will also be 1. So here the coordinate will be 0, 0, 2. So for z-axis, the intercept will be 2. So simply the intercepts of this plane are 1, 1, 2 on the x, y and z-axis respectively. Clear? So in step 2, take the reciprocals and it will be 1, 1, 1 by 2. Okay, so here we have a fraction. So just take the LCM so that all the terms will be simplified. So if you take 2 as a LCM, it will be 2, it will also be 2 and it will be 1. Okay, so just remove the LCM from here. So for this plane, your Miller indices will be 2, 2, 1. Okay, so we will tell you few things about the family of planes, and we will discuss about the 100 family of planes. So basically, what is a family of planes, okay, and why we need to study about the family of planes? So crystal ke andar we have few planes which shows same physical properties, same atomic density, and so many properties which are same in these particular planes. So we consider all these planes belong to a particular family, and because we need not to study the different planes to find or to calculate the different properties for this crystal. So all these planes which are similar in some way, we can write in a same family, okay? So basically we can consider these planes from same family. So we are talking about 100 plane. So we have 6 planes in this family, and first plane is the front face of the unit cell of the crystal lattice. This is 100 plane, and the second plane is 010 plane, this face. Third plane is the upper face, that is 001, and fourth plane is 1/100 plane, okay? So this plane is the backward face of the unit cell, and if you find the intercept of this plane on the 3-axis, on x-axis the intercept will be in negative x direction, okay? So for negative direction we take bar on top of a number, so this will be 1/100 plane. So this is the front face and this is a backward face, okay? So these two planes are in opposite direction. So next plane similarly is 0/1/0, and sixth plane is 0/0/1, okay? So these are the 6 planes belongs to family 100, okay? So you can check at least about the atomic density. In each plane the atomic density is same, right? So these planes are having same physical properties. So, and also in X-ray diffraction you will get the same kind of peak for these planes. So we need to study about the family of planes also. We have so many different family of planes also. So this is just an example. So we studied about the parallel planes. हमने पढ़ा कि the parallel planes are the planes having same Miller indices, okay? So like crystal के अंदर these two planes are parallel, okay? So for these two planes the Miller indices will be same, right? So if you want to calculate the interplanar spacing, okay? So this term interplanar spacing is basically the spacing between the planes which are basically parallel planes, okay? So if we have a set of parallel planes and the separation between these planes is known as interplanar spacing, DHKL. Okay, so don't be confused. Okay, अगर आपको कभी भी interplanar spacing निकालने के लिए कोई क्वेश्चन आता है, okay, so keep in mind the separation is between the set of parallel planes. Okay, सिर्फ parallel planes के लिए ही you can calculate the interplanar spacing, okay? और this term is denoted by DHKL, okay? So like these two planes are parallel and इनके लिए you have Miller indices HKL, okay? So the formula of interplanar spacing will be 1 upon under root h square upon a square plus k square upon b square plus l square upon c square. So HKL are your Miller indices, and A, B and C are the crystallographic axis of this crystal, that is, okay. So is formula se you can calculate the interplanar separation between the planes, okay. So hum example dekh lete hain so that aapko acche se clear ho jaye. So your first example is you have a FCC unit cell, face centered cubic unit cell of copper. And what is the interplanar spacing of 110 planes? Okay, so आपको इस plane के लिए interplanar spacing निकालना है, and you have lattice constant 3.61 × 10⁻¹⁰ meter, right? So आपको a given है, which is basically lattice constant. So आपका a है 3.61 × 10⁻¹⁰ meter. So you will use the formula DHKL equals to 1 upon under root H square upon A square plus K square upon B square plus L square upon C square. आपका crystal है FCC, face centered cubic. तो आपका cubic crystal है means A equals to B equals to C here. So आप तीनों value को equal put कीजिएगा, आपका formula निकल के आएगा DHKL equals to A upon under root H square plus K square plus L square. So put the values of A and HKL, you will get the value of your intraplanar spacing D110, that is 2.55 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So this will be your answer. आपका next problem है, what is a family of planes HKL with an intraplanar spacing of D and D is 1.246 angstrom in nickel and you have A 3.524 angstrom. Okay, so I hope आपको question समझ में आया होगा. You have to find the family of planes. Okay, and आपके पास D है interplanar spacing and A है. Okay, so you will use the same formula. Cubic crystal के लिए directly you can use DHKL equals to A upon under root H square plus K square plus L square. Right, तो आपको family of plane निकालना है, तो आप separate कर लीजिए h square plus k square plus l square वाला term को, and it will be a upon DHKL. A की value 3.524 put कीजिए, and for DHKL your value is 1.246. Okay, so after division you will get 2.828. Right, so h square plus k square plus l square will be square of this term and that will be 7.997 and this term is nearly equal to 8. Okay, क्योंकि you have only integers, okay, in HKL, so we take 8. Okay, so your H square plus K square plus L square will be 8. So you can write 4 plus 4 plus 0 or 4 plus 0 plus 4 or 0 plus 4 plus 4. Okay, so in तीनों ही cases में you will get 8. Okay, you will get 3 planes. Okay, 220, 202 and 022. Okay, but we have to find the family of planes here. So all the planes will be from same family and we can write the family of planes is 220. Okay, so in this way you can calculate the family of planes. I hope the questions are clear to you and okay, if you have any doubt you can ask in comment section. Okay, so thanks.